Hello everyone. In this video, I'm going to show you how to create, manage, and maintain images for unattended deployment in Windows Server 2016. This task is very similar to Lab 6 of Microsoft Official Academic Course Installation, Storage, and Compute with Windows Server 2016 Lab Manual Exam 70-740. First, I will install and configure Windows Deployment Services. Then I will add Windows deployment images that include the installer. Then I will generate an XML file, which is an answer file that helps deployment without user interactions. Then I will check and verify the answer file. And finally, I will configure Windows deployment service for automatic deployment. I will need one domain controller and a server, Windows 10 Assessment and Deployment Kit, and the Operating System Installer ISO image. With Windows Deployment Service in the network, a client can use a Pixie boot and complete an unattended installation of Windows Operating System on the client machine. It is a great tool for installing operating system on hundreds of computers without user interactions. From the server manager of server 4, I go through add roles and features wizard with default settings, and on the select server role, I select Windows deployment service. When the installation finishes, I close it. Then I run Windows Deployment Service from the Tools menu of Server Manager. I expand Servers, and on Server 4, I choose Configure Server. I go through the Windows Deployment Service configuration wizard. On the Pixie Server Initial Setting page, I select Respond to All Client Computers and finish the wizard with default values in all other pages. That is the end of first part, installing and configuring Windows deployment services. On server 4, I create the folder named software on drive C. I open the shared folder called software that was shared on the domain controller. Then I copy Windows Server 2016 installation ISO image file from the software folder of the domain controller to the software folder of server 4. On server 4, I mount Windows Server 2016 installation disk ISO image. From the Windows Deployment Service console, I expand servers and then expand server 4. Then I add a boot image by pointing boot.wim file from the sources folder of the mounted CD/DVD drive. And I finish the add image wizard with default settings in all other pages. Then I add an install image by pointing to install.wim file from the sources folder of the mounted CD/DVD drive. On the available images page, I keep only the image that I want to deploy and finish the add image wizard with default settings in all other pages. When the wizard is finished, that is the end of adding Windows deployment image part of the lab. In this part of the lab, I will generate an XML file that stores and applies applicable settings during the deployment process. On server 4, I copy the adksetup.exe file from the software folder of the domain controller and install.wim file from the sources folder of the CD/DVD drive to the software folder of server 4. I run adksetup.exe at server 4 and that starts the installation of Windows Assessment and Deployment Kit. I go through the wizard with default settings except on the Select the Features You Want to Install page. I keep deployment tools and Windows pre-installation environment and remove all other features. I create a folder for distribution on C drive. Then from start menu, I run Windows System Image Manager. From its tools menu, I create distribution share for the distribution folder that I created before. Then from File menu, I choose Select Windows Image and open install.wim from software directory. Then I select Windows Server 2016 Standard Edition and at the prompt for a new catalog file, I choose to create a new catalog file. Then I set different parameter values and save the answer file. that is the end of generating an XML answer file for unattended deployment. In this part, I will open an XML answer file and validate it for a Windows image. On server 4, I open Windows System Image Manager, select a Windows image or catalog file, and then open an answer file for unattended installation. Then from the Tools menu, I select Validate Answer File. On the message area, if no warning or error messages are found, then the answer file will work fine with the Windows image. Finally, I will configure Windows Deployment Service for automatic deployment. On server 4, I copy the unattended answer file from the software folder to the remote install folder. Then from Server Manager's Tools menu, I run Windows Deployment Service. I expand servers. And from Server 4's Properties Windows Client tab, I select the Enable Unattended Installation. Then I point to Auto Unattended Answer File for corresponding architecture and close the properties window. On the Windows Deployment Service windows, I expand the Install Images node and select Image Group 1. Then from the Windows Server 2016 Server Standard Image Property window, I check Allow Image to Install in Unattended Mode checkbox. Then I select the Auto Unattended Answer File through the Select File button and close the property window. Now I can perform a pixie boot on a new machine and perform an installation of Windows Server 2016 without user interactions. I hope this video was helpful. If you would like to receive notifications on future videos, please make sure you are subscribed to the channel. Thank you for watching.